I actually forget what this one does, so... Rip. You. Loss. You got the loss suffix on there. It does void damage to one target, apparently. Maybe useful, probably not. I found void and earth damage just to look cool, nothing else really. So talk to this guy. Castiga? Or Castigia? I don't know. Nice jumping. Yes, Callum has all the manners. So go down here, and we can get a boat to a volcano, because we're just that cool. Right, these traveling sequences take a while. Not too long, but you have to wait. And there's a cutscene in this one, apparently. Okay. Oh, that's a pretty waterfall there. Yeah, we'll notice this area when we go through it later. Yeah, it does take a while, like I said. So the next place we're going is a freaking volcano. Which is over here. I'm kind of over level for that. This, but that's because I've constantly been just killing those guys that give a lot of experience and money. So, our first enemy here is rocks. Yeah, physical attacks basically do nothing, so all you want to do is use spells on these guys. It doesn't seem to do much, though. Oh well, they don't have many hit points, so... I'm fairly sure that physical attacks do basically nothing, so if you go out here, let's try actually, maybe Sir Wint's fire attack spell, Red Eagle thing will do, the Red Eagle does damage, but this Moon Rifle still does enough damage. Does it actually have an element? I don't actually know. It's probably because these enemies are just under-leveled. Oops, I meant to go equip. No, it doesn't. Okay. Again, our medical herb, that was kind of pointless. Well, at least these fights are relatively easy then. These aren't the only enemies here, of course. 3 XP, are you kidding me? Give me a little more than that, please. This is quite a long... sort of day. Then again, it is kind of 2 days. You notice that little sound that you heard there? I don't know what these guys do. Let's try Pra. Yeah, I'll show you Pra. Oh, okay, void damage seemed to work pretty well there, jeez. Maybe they're weak to that or something. You notice that noise? Was it? Oh well. Maybe you only hear it once or something, I can't remember. So... You can get to this thing by simply walking over. What place is it at? There we go. There's the noise. And you can walk over, but of course you gotta find your way around and get attacked by rocks on the lava. Seems legit. These guys like to drop sweet water. Anti-mantra barrier. What is written? Ream. Ream is the... Nah, I actually just filled it in there. Yeah, the mantra is Reem. R-E-E-M. What that'll do is basically that puts magic defense up to anything, but if you want, and this is why it's useful, really, You can put aqua, ream, and then either mel. I don't know if mel works with this one. It might not. No. Ugh, I had to. You can go forward and like do it quicker than me, but I just messed that up. So put a na on the end. And wait, what the hell? That doesn't work, really. I thought that would work. Maybe I have to put it here. Failure! I thought that would work though. There we go, you have to put Narim, okay. So yeah, that's defense against water, for example. That's a really useful one, actually. Right, well, I'll put that, and I'll put just the regular one. The regular one won't do as much, but it covers against every element, so it can be quite useful. Anyway, where should we go now? I think there's only one way to go, really. Let's use two of these, because they seem to be pretty useful against these guys. Maybe they are weak to void, I don't know. Pretty sure not a lot of enemies were, if any, were weak to void or stuff like that, though. Right, I think I need to head up this way. Right, I've got no clue where I'm going, actually. Is it up this way? I don't know. I've got lost. Right, there's something over here. Sweetwater won't fit my inventory. Yeah, you can only carry 9, so that can be a bit annoying. Damn it! Why, rocks? Why? There's a nice little crossbow thing, though. Oh, and I got more Sweetwater. I don't even know if I'm going in the right direction, I'll be honest. Ooh, a new guy. Wow. He died really fast. That's a blue chest, so I can't open that. Nope. Or one of these guys. Yeah, these enemies are fairly simple. I like how they crumble to the ground first, though. Right, looks like I've pretty much got everything on this side. I'm gonna speed this up a little. So I guess I go down here? I guess. More enemies, goddammit. Well, at least these enemies are fairly simple, anyway. It's not like some of the later places where the normal enemies will just kick your ass. Okay, that was a lot more interesting. I don't think I've actually seen that animation before. Are we down here? I don't even know. Looks like I'm just floundering about then, I have no clue where I'm going. It definitely is the top of the volcano. Okay guys, I'm gonna be right back. Well, looks like this is the first episode that's gonna be split into two parts, but there was a path that I forgot to take, and now I see where it is. Basically, the first down path that I saw, I missed. So, you go in here, and you're like, shit, there's lava everywhere. Oh. Well, I've already used that, actually. Just walk forward. And that's all you need to do. So here's Solwyn here. We are regular archaeologists. Flashback time, I guess. Looks a bit paranoid there. Okay. Lovely. So here's our other guy here, Sork, and yeah, okay, prepared to see Yah a lot, and I'm instantly reminded of Walker, which could be a good thing, could be a bad thing. Is not good, Yah. Only sword, my sword. You'll see about that later. And Callum acts just like Callum would, quite. So apparently we're getting a new teammate. Me. Ninja man over here. Who acts nothing like a ninja, but okay. Sork is great. Don't care what you say. Gramps. Yeah, he doesn't seem too happy about that one. Right, here's Sork. Notice that they will, I'll rest here. I wonder if I save. Wait. One day has elapsed. Okay. I need to get to the bottom of the mountain anyway. I'll save anyway, just in case. I doubt anything's really going to trouble me. Here's Sork. He's your, he's your melee guy, basically. Class bodyguard. He's actually really powerful eventually, but right now he's okay. He will never have any MP though, so he's never really going to be able to do much magic. And yeah, there's Sork over there down the bottom. I'll leave him in the front row because he'll do more damage there. And we gotta climb down to the bottom of this mountain. So you can see the way I came up. I don't know why I got lost, it's a pretty simple path, it's just I went too far. I don't think Sork's even going to get to attack unless I change the turn order. So, yes, this has been taking a while, but when we get to the bottom of here, then... Okay, that was kind of... Oh well. When we get to the bottom of here, then... This little chapter will end. Okay, 9 damage, lol. I believe Sork has a nice little animation when he does cast magic, though. Well, let me try this. So, I can reorganize the order and then just cast that, I guess. Wait, I wanted you to cast. Oh, I was casting with Serwin for some reason. Yeah, I forgot. You have to obviously do it by the first party member first, and then you can do it. The turn order goes back to normal, so attack, attack, and then you do it. Okay. He takes off his mask. Right, there you go. Come on, let's go. And then you take the boat back. Yeah, so it's been fairly long so far. So yeah, this will be split into two videos. And you got to watch going through the forest again, which we still haven't been to. So after this, I'm going to write down Serwant's mantras, even though there's not too many useful ones there, honestly. The Mel suffix might be useful. The Lus, I think Sion had already had some of them, so that's not that useful. So I may just like inscribe some of the other ones, like the wind damage and stuff like that, which I don't have right now. Is it still one day? Nope, 2 days have elapsed. Well, we got to talk to the doctor guy. So I'm gonna go do that first, and then I'll go and finish this at the end. Gotta go upstairs. More of these guys. Screw you. I've been doing stuff, right? Oh, we gotta go to Horn Cave then. And nighttime only, apparently. And be quick about it. Damn it. Voice? Wait, what? What's going on? Legend, you're kinda useless. What do we see? Wait, what? Huh. I wonder... I thought the world was polluted. Biotechnology. Well, we're gonna did someone really say I there? Well, looks like we're gonna find out who actually done that next time. With Reza's story, part 2. Or day 2, or whatever. But for now, that's been a rather lengthy first day with Serwant. He's a pretty cool guy, as you've seen. He's actually the highest leveled of our 3 characters so far. So I'll see you guys next time.